sir. The God of the Bible is just. Not like Allah, because when Muhammad did sex with a 6-9-year-old child, Allah told me to do. When he married more women, Allah told me to do. When he married his, when his married daughter-in-law, his own daughter-in-law, Allah told me to do. Every time Allah told me to do, Allah told me to do, Allah told me to do. Unlike the God of Bible, the God of the Bible is just. Because Moses is mentioned in Quran. You are not follower of Moses? Are you not follower of Moses? No, I'm quoting Torah. We don't follow the law. Thank you. Listen here. We don't follow the law of Moses. Thank you.
You know Hosanna was to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
He was his sister's wife, sister's daughter.
Cousin.
Yeah.
He was a cousin of Muhammad Sallallahu.
So thank you for agreeing. You can marry your cousin also.
Yes.
So you can marry your cousin. You can marry your daughter-in-law. And they don't have relation when you marry with them. Thank you. Listen. You have a problem. David's wife was taken from David because David did a sin, but you don't have a problem. Muhammad took his own son's wife and slept with her.
Perfect.
Ask Steve.
Are you Christian ready for one?
No, no.
Go on. Are you Christian ready for
one? No.
I have one question.
Abbas, I have one question.
No, you have many questions.
I have one question.
Be honest here, brother. Wasn't it been answering all the questions?
Yes. No. No, you did tap dancing. You shut up. Tap dancing. You did tap dancing.
Didn't I change your questions?
Tap dancing.
I tried. Right or wrong?
No.
Can I ask you one question then?
You have to answer first.
Shut up.
Because you have a lot of questions.
You see these Christians. Who can only ask questions.
Who is responsible for Christian faith?
He's not talking
my
to
question is, about
but I'm talking to
my
him.
My question is,
I am talking to him.
You believe
I'm talking
your God,
to him.
Your God is a moral God. He has morality, yeah, God.
Of course.
And he's just. Now my question to you is, that in the story of David and Bathsheba, and you like to answer this question as well, you said, David commit adultery with Bathsheba.
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Now David, God says, I will punish you. What God says, I will take your wives and give it to the neighbor. And your neighbor will do to them what you've done in secret, he will done in the open. Meaning, David committed.
Do you think Christians look at
no,
that?
No.
Okay. I will answer. I will answer.
I
don't really mind.
I am saying this is the God's doing. Yeah, God is doing that. And you believe in that God. God of the Old Testament.
Yeah,
he's the same God of the New Testament.
But he doesn't apply to Christians.
No, I'm not saying he applies to you. I'm saying that's what God did. My question is, why wives of the David has to go and sleep with the neighbor when it was the David who committed adultery?
It was the punishment given by God. This shows the God of the Bible is just, because when David did adultery, even being a prophet, God punished David. Okay, not like Allah when he says Muhammad. Let me finish. The God of the Bible is just. He do justice even with his prophet. If his prophet do sin, he punishes him. Not like Allah. Allah when he did Muhammad.
Don't go to Islam.
No, I'm showing you. I'm asking.
Be
I'm answering. Let me answer. I said the God of the Bible. See, no one listen.
Answer.
The God of the Bible is just. Not like Allah, because when Muhammad did sex with a 6-9-year-old child, Allah told me to do. When he married more women, Allah told me to do. When he married his, when his married daughter-in-law, his own daughter-in-law, Allah told me to do. Every time Allah told me to do, Allah told me to do, Allah told me to do. Unlike the God of Bible, the God of the Bible is just.
Before you ask another question, do you believe
he's a Muslim? One second, my question hasn't finished yet.
Did Allah punish Muhammad?
My question hasn't finished
yet. Do you believe that? Yes or no?
My question was, why God give wives of the David to the neighbor?
Because the God of the Bible is just.
His answer is, look, Muhammad did that.
No.
How that is?
You're not listening.
How is the answer?
Because the God of the Bible, what David did, what David did, the story, my brother, listen. Because the story, the David, he took his friend's wife and he slept with her. So God got anger. Listen, and we condemned it. We don't support it, unlike you. You support a six-year marriage.
No.
Second time. Yeah. So
we look at Jesus Christ.
He's a God. Why don't you go to Jesus? Because when you go to Jesus and you compare Jesus to Muhammad, you know what's going to happen. That's why you always go to the Old Testament.
No. I answered.
No, you didn't.
In Christianity, yeah, in Christianity. Let me answer.
What is justice? Justice is the one who done the sin should be punished. That's justice, yes?
He punished him.
No, hang on.
He punished David.
David committed the sin according to the law of Moses, Deuteronomy 22.
Let him go.
According to the law of Moses, yes, you can make it. According to the law of Moses, adulterer should be stoned to death. According to the law of Moses, adulterer should be stoned to death, Deuteronomy 22. Now, David and Bathsheba committed adultery.
I'm talking right now, brother, have some courage, let me speak.
According to the law of Moses, David and Bathsheba should be stoned to death. But God didn't do that. God, instead of that, God say his wife go and sleep with the neighbor.
No.
That's what God says.
Let me explain.
So basically, if you read through 2 Samuel 12, for example, in 2 Samuel 12, right, you see clearly that, let me read this. Let me get the verse out. Sorry, I want to take my time with this. Just excuse me.
2 Samuel chapter 12.
Yeah. I'm going there. You don't have to worry. All right. So if you read 2 Samuel 12, what does it say?
If they go to Jesus, then Muhammad, they can't win them. That's what I always do.
Wherefore? So let's read here from this. And I gave thee, this is what Nathan says. I'm reading from 7, sorry. And Nathan said to David, so this is Nathan prophesying about what God is saying to him. So Nathan is a prophet, by the way. He's prophesying what David's saying to him. And Nathan said to David, thou art the man, thus saith the Lord God of Israel. I anointed thee king over Israel, and I have delivered thee out of the hand of Saul. And I gave thee thy master's house and thy master's wives into thy bosom, and gave thee the house of Israel and of Judah. And if it had to be too little, I'll skip past that because it needs to be. Right. Wherefore hast thou, you David, despised the commandment of the Lord to do evil in his sight? Thou hast killed Uriah the Hittite with the sword, because he caused Uriah the Hittite to be killed in the previous chapter. We see in chapter 11 that he actually caused Uriah the Hittite to be led into battle and to be killed. Right, let's read on. Right here, thou to be killed with a sword, and has taken his wife to be thy wife, and has slain him with the sword of the children of Ammon. Now therefore, the sword shall never depart from thine house. So what do we see here? God is bringing justice upon David. He's saying the sword will never depart from his house, right? Because thou hast despised me, and has taken the wife of Uriah. What did he do? He took the wife of Uriah and to be his wife. What does it say here? Yeah? Thus saith the Lord, behold, I'll raise up evil against thee out of thine own house, and I will take thy wife before thine eyes. That's what he did. So if you read later on in chapter 18 of this same book, 2 Samuel chapter 18, yeah, his own wives are given to his son Absalom, right? So his wives are taken from him the same way he took the wife of Uriah the Hittite. Let's go on. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I'll raise up evil against thee out of thine own house, and I will take thy wives before thine eyes, and I'll give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with them. It with thy wives in the light in the sight of the sun. For thou didst see it secretly, but I will do this thing before all Israel. What happened is Absalom had sex with these slaves, with this concubine, sorry, not slaves, before all Israel. Literally, he was open about it. He said, tell everybody this has happened. I'm taking David's wife. Right. And David said unto Nathan, right? I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord also have put away thy sin. Thou shalt not die. So the Lord is allowed to, in his own commandments, his own justification, to take away the sins of certain people. Remember, David is a king. He's not under the laws of the people in Deuteronomy, because he's the one who enforces the laws. As mentioned, there are covenant laws within Israel. For example, during that time, there were judges in Israel. In Deuteronomy, there were judges in Israel to judge between good and evil. Now there is a king. How do you judge a king? Nobody can judge a king. Nobody can stone him for adultery at all, because he is the king. So what God has done, instead, he said, I will punish you for what you did to Uriah the Hittite. I'll punish you for your sin. Your wives will be taken as concubines by other people, and the sword shall never depart from your house. Let's read this. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that is born of thee shall die. So even the child that David had made with Bathsheba out of adultery had was basically not killed, obviously, but basically was removed by God, basically, for the actions he caused. So basically, all we see here is David constantly being rebuked and him being told that all these punishment will be placed upon him based upon his actions and what he did to Uriah. Bear in mind that God himself is the just lawgiver. He can choose whether he inflicts a judge or he inflicts justice or not. And also, David is king. He is not the same as a peasant during the time of Deuteronomy. A peasant to be judged will be judged by judges. That's what it says in Deuteronomy 1:6. They'll be judged by judges. There is no judges for the king because the king is sovereign. So what did God do? He brings inflictions and punishments on them. Sorry, I'm
getting... Can I say now something?
Yeah, go ahead.
You made a few points here. You say the law of Moses does not fall on the king of Israel. You have to prove that from the Bible, that the king is not under the law of Moses, because that's what you said.
Okay, I'll show this.
I haven't finished. I'm just starting. Later on your own turn. So you have to prove that. So David was not under the law of Moses. But Bathsheba was. Bathsheba fall under the law of Moses because she was not king or queen. Why Bathsheba wasn't stoned to death according to Deuteronomy 22:22? Secondly, if God could not punish David, what David's wife has to do with it? Why David's wife has to go and sleep with a neighbor? They were innocent. They didn't ask David to go and sleep with Bathsheba. So why they were punished?
Do you want to go after him more?
I'm talking about
No, you can keep talking. I'm just talking to him.
Why? No, I want you to listen. I want you to listen to what I'm saying. So point
here. Oh, calm down.
Point here is, why his wives have to go and sleep with the neighbor? And listen what happened here. What David did in the secret, he committed adultery in the secret, which is a sin. And the God says, what you did in the secret, I will do it in the open of Israel. I mean, God make it adultery, open for all Israel to see. Not God going to give your wife for to marry to the other person, but he will commit adultery as you done in secret. I will make it do in the open. I say, what kind of a just God is that? The one who's the one sinner who done the sin, he should be punished, not his wife. His wife has nothing to do with it. If God doesn't want to punish David, I can understand that he's king. But why wives have to go and sleep with the neighbor? That's not a just God. It's like saying that I am the one king and I cheat on my wife and I slept with the neighbor. Now my wife has to sleep with somebody else's neighbor. This is not just God. This is unjust God. God is the holy. God doesn't behave like that. And if it's wrong to say to me...
Can you fire your pen, please? Because it's taking too long.
This is how a pimp would act and not God. So this is not a just God. Do not justify such an action of God. God will never do that. And that will
never... Are you going to fire your pen?
And we do not...
You're going to get there yet.
We never believe that David committed adultery. Quran and Sunnah never says that. It's your Bible says that. And in the Bible, David should have been punished. He wasn't.
Are you done? So, you're not making any point.
I'm trying to say God should not do justice.
God should be just.
Can I finish? Because I actually want to speak.
This is not
okay. Justice. So basically, he says that our God is like a pimp, right? But his God in Surah 2:24 says that
you
can literally take
brother.
That you can literally take slave girls. That's what his God says. So his God's the pimp, not ours. Let's be honest. Yeah. Anyway, he stated that I have to show him somewhere where the laws that apply to Moses do not apply to David. Basically, let's read in Deuteronomy 5:3, which you must have missed because you don't read the Bible.
Yeah.
The Lord made not this covenant with our fathers, but with us, even us who are all of us here alive to this day. Now, Deuteronomy 6:12. Now these commandments, the statutes, the judgments, which the Lord your God commanded to teach you, that ye might do them in the land wherever you go to possess. That's the land they did possess, which is Israel. Yeah? That thou mightest fear the Lord thy God to keep... Can I finish?
Can I finish?
Okay. You must have forgot your own points. Because before that, you said to me, I have to find you somewhere where God... Can I finish? Are you that scared? You don't want to let me finish?
Go on.
Okay. So you said to me earlier on, yeah, I have to show you somewhere. Oh, dude, what's going on?
Right.
Okay, so...
Now.
Yeah, the police report. Anyway, you said to me... I have to show you somewhere where the commandments are done away with for not for David. And I've said, look here, this is for the Israelites. This command is given to the Israelites. Now, these are the commandments, the statutes and the judgments which the Lord your God commanded to teach you, that ye might do them in the land wherever you go to possess it, that thou mightest fear the Lord thy God to keep all his statutes and his commandments which I command thee to thy son and thy son's son all the days of thy life. I'm reading Deuteronomy 6:1-2. Right. And also, this is Deuteronomy 7 to 9, just holding in the point. Now, therefore, that's the wrong verse. Sorry.
Also, I'll quote one verse.
You need to show
that
me.
Exodus 34:7 says that. Oh, yeah, you agree. The iniquity of the fathers of the on the children's and the generations. That means if you do some iniquity, the God of the Bible will put this curse to your children's as well as your family. So the God of the Bible is just, it's already said in the Exodus.
Okay, so Abbas's previous point, I want to get to your previous points 1 minute. Yeah? Abbas's previous points were about the fact that, why were the women taken? Why were they taken captive? This happened
not
a lot.
They go and sleep
they didn't just go to sleep, they were taken captive. You read Deuteronomy chapter, no, not Deuteronomy chapter, 2 Samuel chapter 18, for example. They're literally taken captive by Absalom after David's kingdom is taken captive. And it's taken captive because as David goes out, his kingdom is taken over by Absalom through the providence of God. Because as God says, the sword will never depart you from your kingdom. He literally states that in the verse I just read. Isn't a problem for God to initiate crimes against even the people, the people involved, because he will do that. That's not a problem for us.
I think you're jumping the gun here. What I'm saying is, God is saying that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah, and he does it.
You slept with somebody's wife. Yeah. Your wife says go and sleep with somebody else. This, I say, God don't do like that. This is not a justice of God. God can say, okay, I can punish you or I cannot punish you. But what I'm saying is, wives have no part in that. Wives are not in that sin. They didn't do nothing wrong. Why wives have to pay the price of what David has done? This is not a justice.
The wives didn't pay the price. This is not what justice. Happened? Through the providence of God, if you read Deuteronomy 18, it is providence. Because God himself, God himself did not take their wives and say, I'm giving them to Absalom. No. He allowed David's kingdom to be taken over by Absalom, and therefore his wives were taken as concubines.
That is the doing.
That was the punishment. As God says, the sword shall not depart from your kingdom.
You are ignoring this verse, what this clearly says. God says this. Thus says the Lord, this is his will. Behold, I will raise up evil against you out of your own house.
Exactly.
And I will take your wives before your eyes and give them to your neighbor.
His providence.
Who's giving to the neighbor? Is it God giving
divine
to the neighbor?
Divine providence. Remember, it's not a providence. if you read in context,
God
Abbas,
is not saying that
2 Samuel
that is going to
18,
God
right?
Say, I
isn't God
that.
That's lifting the wives out and putting them into Absalom's house? No.
This is the work of God.
Well, yeah, obviously, I believe it's the work of God.
And give it to your neighbor. And you
but you're not listening to what I'm saying. I believe it's the work of God. I did not deny it was the work of God.
That's the will of God.
I believe it's the work of God. Because God said he would do that.
So my question is, why God done that to his wife?
But why is that unjust? Why is it unjust? Why is it unjust for David's property and his kingdom be taken? Bearing in mind, I want everybody to bear in mind, that he stole Uriah the Hittite's wife, he took her, he had sex with her, and he had a child with her.
It's evil.
So
evil.
The same judgment that was done on him was placed upon him.
No,
it's not a problem.
No, it's not.
His wife was taken, so therefore David's wife was taken. It's not a problem for us.
It's like if I punch somebody, that person will punch my wife. That is not justice. I should have received the punch back. That is the justice. My wife has nothing to do with it. In the same way, David's wife has nothing to do with it. And remember what I said. David, God said, what you done in secret, I will make it do happen in open. What David done in the secret? He commit adultery, a sin in secret.
And what did David do?
God said,
he stole another man's wife.
I'm going to happen in the open.
So the same thing was done to David that he did to another person. That is not a problem for our religion. You keep getting it wrong, Abbas. You're going to have to try again.
So God, what do you call it? The word is, God is make that sin happen in the open. I mean, what kind of a God is making this kind of adultery taking place in the open?
God says he will reveal those things in our hiding place. That's what he says in the Bible.
God has a problem that David did a sin, and David took the wife of David's and gave to other. That is the God of Bible who does justice. But Abbas, that's the justice, because I read you as the chapter Exodus where God says,
what?
God curses the generation. If Adam did sin, we are in sin also, because that is the sin of generation. So you have a problem. Listen, you have a problem. David's wife was taken from David because David did a sin, but you don't have a problem. Muhammad took his own son's wife and slept with her. How come your God is justice? How come your God is justice? My God is justice.
I will answer this question.
My God, listen. Let me explain.
Don't hide behind Islam.
No, I'm not hiding behind Islam. You don't want to speak about Islam. Listen. He have a problem. How come the God of Bible take David's wife and give to other? I said that is the justice because David did the same thing with others. God of the Bible is just. Unlike your God who gives his son's wife to Muhammad and said you can sleep with her and you don't have problem with that.
Is the David the sinner or his wife the sinner?
David as well as his generation.
So
the God is God give curse to generation. Read Exodus chapter.
The punishment punishment of adultery. Punishment of adultery in Deuteronomy 22:22 is stoned to death. Bathsheba should be stoned to death. David should be stoned to death. Instead of David stoned to death, the punishment of God is that David, you're going to live, you have your kingdom, and you're going to get your kingdom back again. But your wives have to go and sleep with your neighbor. Remember, his wife who sleep with Absalom, and David took back again his kingdom back. David was king again. So there was punishment over David was.
So,
he was still a king, still alive, long live.
And according,
his wife has to go and sleep with the neighbor. Can't you? Why don't you comprehend?
I'm answering you. Listen.
Why don't you comprehend one simple thing?
Why
don't you comprehend one simple
just
thing?
One point.
His wife has nothing to do with it. Why his wife has to go and sleep with the neighbor and commit adultery? That is not a God. God doesn't behave like that. God should punish
his religion.
You say Exodus 34 says the iniquity of the fathers will follow the children. I say that's also unjust.
That's unjust.
That's unjust, of course.
Okay.
Not unjust. That's unjust. God does not bring the sin to the children. He shouldn't. Because your Ezekiel chapter 20 says,
Why?
Sins of the fathers will not follow the
offense,
children.
Neither the sin. So
there's a contradiction in the Bible. One place says,
how come?
The sins of the fathers.
Abbas, how can you speak about sin? How can you speak about sin when it in your hadith it says that Allah has put the sin in Adam's life 40 years before Adam was born?
So you can't answer the question.
No, I'm answering you. I'm answering by your logic.
You can't
because I answered you. David did sin. Listen.
I will answer.
Let me answer. You have a problem. The why did God give David's wife to others?
That's wrong.
Because that's wrong.
Of course wrong.
So Allah is wrong. Allah is wrong when Muhammad fight with unbelievers and took their wives. That is also injustice.
No, that's not.
If this is injustice, that is also injustice.
Have we done with your? You can't answer the question.
No, I have answered you. I have answered you. I have answered you.
Let people judge.
If the God of the Bible is injustice for giving David's wife to others, God of Quran is also injustice by taking other wives and giving to Muhammad and his companion. That is also sin.
And I'm going to answer as a Muslim from the Quran and Islam and Hadith, but it's clear that you run towards Islam.
Now your question, you asked his question, I'll answer the thing you said about Christianity.
You wouldn't be running to Islam.
You said the wife of his son.
Yeah.
His son, Muhammad Sallam, got it. What's wrong with that?
So it's not wrong to sleep with your daughter-in-law.
Daughter-in-law?
Yeah.
Did he sleep with the daughter-in-law?
He didn't sleep.
She was ex-wife of his son-in-law.
His adopted son.
Ex-wife.
What was the name of the
Zen.
Son? Zen. Yeah. What was the wife's name?
Zainab,
okay. Yeah. So you are okay.
So what?
Muhammad slept with his son's wife.
He didn't slip.
Ex-wife
is not a wife.
So
when you say about wife, you must say she was ex-wife.
So
she was available for anyone to marry now.
Okay, so
he married with her. He didn't just sleep with her. He married with her. So he didn't sleep with his wife.
I'll let you two finish and I want to ask you.
He didn't sleep with his son's wife. You're wrong there. He slept.
Ex-wife
of his adopted son.
Okay. I got it. Yeah. So isn't it injustice with Zayed? Because Zayed, the woman which he was sleeping with her, which he saw naked, and after a few days he's calling him mother. Mama.
Spiritually.
So now he's going spiritually. When did Islam start believing spirituals?
Spiritually.
When did Islam start believing spirituality? So, listen. Don't check. Let me finish.
When they call them, we call them as the spiritual our mothers, like because they are the wives of the Prophet. So spiritually they are, but not literally. She was not his literal mother. The point here is that when he slept with
a literal Zainab, not mother.
When we slept with Zainab, he married her. Yeah. So mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong in Islam to marry somebody's ex-wife. There's nothing wrong with that.
There's nothing wrong with that. Even your son's wife.
Why? Your own son's ex-wife. Why do you think that's
wrong? Why? I will tell you. Because according to the law of Moses, in Deuteronomy said you should not sleep with your daughter-in-law because the daughter-in-law is like your own daughter. Amen. Treat her with like your own daughter. Okay. So why you are trying to say that Allah said and Muhammad did, he slept with his ex.
Why law of Moses applied on Moses?
Because Moses is mentioned in Quran. You are not follower of Moses?
According to you.
Are you not follower of Moses?
According to me, no.
No, I am quoting Torah. I am Torah.
We don't follow the law of Moses.
You don't follow the law. Thank you. Listening. We don't follow the law of Moses. Thank you. Do you follow the law of Jesus?
We follow
the law of Jesus.
The law of Moses is only for the Jew.
Wait.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave us a law for all mankind.
Okay.
The law of blood relation between Muhammad and his son-in-law.
Brother, one second. You see how hypocrite you are?
I'm not hypocrite.
I'll tell you why.
Simple.
You say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam should follow the law of Moses. Earlier you say David should not fall under the law of Moses.
No, because we believe in the new covenant. We don't believe in the old covenant.
So David didn't. We say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the prophet of God. He's more than a king. He was the prophet of God.
Okay.
So why should he follow the law of Moses?
Yeah, and David was the prophet of God. Even though,
This
is what I mean. It's not
even though according to you.
So thanks.
Even you don't.
So thanks for proving my point. So when it comes to Bible, the God of Bible punishes his own prophet David for doing adultery. But when it comes to Islam, it doesn't punish. Allah doesn't punish his own prophet for doing adultery. That is the difference between God of Bible and God of Islam. You prove from your own mouth, Abbas, that you said that God of the Bible punishes the prophets himself for doing adultery. We accept it. We don't say no. But when it comes to Islam, your prophet is sleeping with his own son's wife and saying it's okay. Now, why?
Ex-wife is adopted son.
So, okay. Ex-wife. So listen.
Are you
trying to say? No, listen. Bro.
Your God sleeping with somebody.
Listen.
Son.
Zayed was calling.
Oh, it's okay.
Listen. Listen. So Zayed was calling Zainab, his wife. He did sex with her. He saw her naked. And when Muhammad married Zainab, Zay started calling Zainab mama, mama. Okay, what an excuse. So,
show me.
For example, she's not her mother.
No, she's not her mother. You said he called her mama, mama.
Okay.
Show me.
So,
are we saying
Muhammad is the father of Zaid? Muhammad is father of Zaid?
Not real father.
He's the father or no?
He's the adopted father or no? Adopted father.
Yeah, so adopted father's wife is who?
No, but he was not
adopted. Father's wife is who?
He was not adopted.
I'm answering you.
At that time, he was not his son anymore, adopted son anymore. He was not.
Sorry?
He was adopted son, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they are not your son. He was
not
adopted
anymore.
He was a free man at that time, and he was not his adopted son anymore.
Who was a free man?
Zayd.
He's a slave. He was his son.
But he was a slave.
Yeah. Then he adopted him. And he freed him as well. And then he was not his son.
No.
He never called Zainab mama, mama, as you say.
No.
Or do you know who Zainab
if
was?
If Zainab called his papa, papa.
Mm. Do you know who Zainab was to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam? He was his sister's wife, daughter.
Cousin.
Cousin, yeah.
He was a cousin of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. So thank you for agreeing. You can marry your cousin also.
Yes.
So you can marry your cousin. You can marry your daughter-in-law. And they don't have relation when you marry with them. Thank you. Thanks for proving God of Bible is not the God of Quran. Thank you. Amen. Hallelujah.
Who said you can't marry a cousin? Who say you can't marry a cousin?
You are saying you marry your cousin.
What's wrong with marrying a cousin?
Your cousin is not your sister.
What's wrong? Dude, shoot to me.
Are you nuts? Cousins are not your sisters.
Cousins are not your sisters. Listen.
Why?
Oh, no.
So Abbas,
West as well. People were marrying cousins.
Abbas, sorry to say.
People are marrying cousins.
Sorry to say, Abbas. Why should listen as a Christian? Listen, Abbas. Abbas, listen.
Your Bible says that
you are lost. You are lost. Your Muhammad was lost. Listen, 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 listen. Bro, bro, bro. Listen, listen. Why should I allow any Muslim man to enter in my house when they themselves consider their cousins as wife? Why should I enter? Why should I allow you people? Because you people said that you can marry your cousins. If you can marry your own cousins, own daughter-in-law, why should we agree? No, I'm making sense. I don't understand Chinese. You came here.
He meant Muslims. No, he came in one type of race.
No. He said.
What is it? Stop being Muslim. You can stop being Muslim. Oh, well, that's the problem then, is it? Because then I can't stop shaking. If you're not Muslim, then I can't stop shaking.
You want to continue?
Oh, do you want to continue?
Yeah.
Calm down. I want to hear what Holy Spirit
should be. The Holy Spirit is God, my friend. You need to have respect.
He's
shaking, bro.
Talking about biology, then you lot go crazy. Come on. Biology,
if you are composed, you wouldn't be Muslim.
Adam and Eve, and then you lot get all like lost.
Okay, Abbas.
No.
Abbas, well, we are actually talking to Abbas. So if you want to come round, Abbas.
We're having
a conversation. These guys came.
Why would you let me in your house?
Right, we're gonna attack you.
No, I didn't say that. I said that. Why should I allow any of your people?
Sorry. Give it to him.
Yeah.
Your voice down.
Why should you allow people to enter in your house? Why?
Because you don't consider your cousins as a cousin. You don't consider your daughter-in-law as a daughter-in-law. Cousins are not. No, only in Islam. Ask any religion.
When you say daughter-in-law,
show me. Okay,
if it's not his daughter-in-law, okay. It's his adopted son.
Adopted son is
not his blood. In Islam, a real son's ex-wife, you cannot marry. But he was not his real son. You must understand that.
So
that was his adopted son. That was not his.
So let me ask you: am I your brother?
Sorry?
Am I your brother?
In humanity, yes.
So why should I trust you?
In humanity.
Why should I trust you as a brother?
No,
because
you're not
I can't trust you. Because if
in humanity, you are son from Adam. You are from Adam, and I'm from.
That's
Adam.
That's false thing. That's false thing.
I don't said the verse. I'm reading the verse.
That's a false thing. What you're reading?
Teri madi pencho.
Teri madi pencho.
Teri madi.
Teri madi.
Teri madi
pencho.
Pencho.
Teri ma.
Okay.
Now your Bible says you should not allow non-Christians into your house. You should not greet.
No, not non-Christian.
Yes.
I can trust my Hindu friend because I know in their religion. Why?
Christian or Hindu? Bible says.
I'm a Christian.
I'll show you. The one who doesn't come with the same teaching. Are non-Christians, are they?
Let him be accursed.
Thank you. Thanks for proving my point. You don't come with the same teaching.
Exactly. Does Hindu come with the same teaching?
No.
Exactly.
So, but they are far better than you, my brother.
They
are far better. I can trust him when he comes in my house. Why should I?
Your Bible
says, love your neighbor as yourself. If I love my neighbor as myself,
your Bible says, anyone comes with a different teaching.
It applies to Muslim.
Yeah, exactly.
Muslim. God bless you.
You are so friendly.
God bless you.
You are so friendly.
But
you cannot allow a Muslim in your house.
No.
The Bible said that when they claim to be Christian, but they teach wrong.
He doesn't say that.
That's what he said. That's the context.
He says anyone come with a different teaching than yours.
Let them be accursed.
Should not greet them and should not let enter in your house. He says in John 1.
John 1, letter of John.
John 1.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Where are you from?
So we are talking about how friendly you people are. That if I don't come with the same teaching,
Asian looks same.
It's Muslim as well, yeah?
No. Can I just quickly answer that question?
I'm not so stupid to be a Muslim.
Okay, so basically, right? So basically, Abbas said earlier, and it's a bit louder here, but Abbas said earlier that basically, what is just about the Amalekites, about David? taking Uriah's wife and kidnapping. What you have to understand is David was punished. As I mentioned before, David was punished when God says that the sword will not depart from your house. And then literally after that, in the next five chapters, all you see is David's own sons being killed. For example, his son, I can't remember the name, but three of his sons were killed. His daughter, Tamar, I think her name was, she was raped by her own brother. And all you see is that all you see is a constant calamities befalling David, right? We have to understand that the Bible is to be taken in context and not to be read outside of it, right? And when we read what he did to Uriah, David didn't exactly kill Uriah, but he did, in chapter 11 of 2 Samuel, allow Uriah to be killed based on the premise that he was jealous about Uriah being Bathsheba's wife, right? You have to take this into context when you read the Bible. You can't just read the Bible out of context like a bass and claim that it's unfair what happened in regards to the people's wife being taken. Understand that God is just. And he brings the iniquities on the next generation of those who hate him, right? That's what it says in Deuteronomy. Bearing that in mind, I think it's fair enough to say that if certain person's wife is taken, taken from another person, right? It's fair enough to say that person's wives or concubines should be taken as well. And that's what happens in chapter 18 with Absalom.
Let's give him a chance to wrap up.
My problem in 2 Samuel is this. If God is just, then the God should not punish the innocent person. Here, David commits sin. And according to Deuteronomy 22:22, the adulterer should be stoned to death. And David fall under the law of Moses. He was an Israelite. So does Bathsheba. So my question is, if they commit adultery, they should be stoned to death. Not his wife should go and sleep with the neighbor. What kind of a God is giving the wives of the sinner to go and do more sin with the neighbor? So this, I say, is unjust God. And I cannot believe in such a God who is so unjust in taking the innocent people. But punish David. If you don't want to punish David, what his wives has to do with it? So this was the will of God. God is not prophesying that's going to happen. He said, I will do it. What you done in the secret, adultery, I will make it happen in the open, adultery. Because he said, what you done, I will do as well. So God does not make adultery to happen. The wives are totally innocent. It's like this, as I said. If I commit adultery with a neighbor, the judge say, okay, you are a naughty boy. Now your wife has to go and sleep with the neighbor. This is really blasphemy against God. And this is why I reject Bible. The God could never do that. God is holy. He will never do that. This is the work of demon and the word of men enter in the Bible. And that's why Bible, it doesn't make sense. It's just totally, it's just nonsensical. That's what I want to say.
Thank you.
Give it to him. No.
Thank you, Abbas.
All right, nice to see you, bro. Nice talking to you anyway,
man. It's good to meet you. So, Abbas made a point that the God of the Bible is unjust. But in fact, the God of the Bible is not unjust, it's just. If you read the Genesis chapter, God says the curse will be whoever denies God and whoever doesn't follow the laws of God, the curse will be upon him as well as his generation. It's also mentioned in the Exodus and also in the Samuels. God did the same thing when he punished David for being unjust with his colleague or with his partner. And God punished David as well as his family. So that shows the God of the Bible is just, not unjust. Unlike Abbas God, Allah, who tells Muhammad to sleep with his daughter-in-law. Unlike Muhammad's God, who tells you can sleep with your sex slaves. You can marry as many women you can. And you can do sex with other women without marrying them. So this shows the God of the Bible is not of the God of the Quran. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve. Thank
you.
Thank you, bro. Fire. Yes, it's bro. Thank you, Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean. Yeah. Thank you, bro. You want to do a wrap up?
What's up?
Well, we wrap up?
He wasn't really involved in the conversation.
You want me to wrap up as well?
No.
I like to wrap up.